of you to stop what you're doing and listen. Cannonball!
Billy?
Billy!
Daddy!
Today I'll be investigating halogen displacement reactions. By using these reactions, I'll be able to compare the reactivity of the halogens, otherwise known as group 7 in the periodic table. I'll also be able to show you how I can extract the halogens using organic solvents. So I have with me a selection of halogens. Now these are chlorine, bromine and iodine, all dissolved in water. Now with these, we're going to react them with some potassium halides. Now a halide is a binary compound. It is one part halogen atom bound to one other atom which is less electronegative, in this case potassium, which I have here. As always guys, before we start the experiment, we're going to think of some safety aspects. Now with all chemistry practicals, we're going to wear our safety goggles, but also we're going to try and keep the test tube stoppered at all times, as some of the gases given off can be quite toxic. For example, chlorine gas used by the Germans in World War I can react with the water in your lungs to create hydrochloric acid, which as you imagine can't be a very good thing at all.
Everybody else, quite content to join in with my little scheme of marching up and down the square?
Sarge?
Yes, Wycliffe, what is it?
Well, I'm learning the piano.
Learning the piano?
Yes, Sarge.
And I suppose you want to go and practice, eh? Marching up and down the square, not good enough for you, eh?
Well,
right, off you go! Oh. Now! What about the rest of you?
We're also going to wear gloves, just to protect our hands from any possible spillages. So let's recap on what we need.
Drop-in pipettes, some gloves, some test tubes and rubber bones,
4 cm cubed of bromine water, 1 molar potassium bromide solution, 4 cm cubed of chlorine water, 1 molar potassium chloride solution, 4 cm cubed of iodine water, 1 molar potassium iodide solution, and finally our organic solvent cyclohexane. So to begin guys, we're going to take a dropping pipette and we're going to add 2 cm cubed of chlorine water to potassium bromide and potassium iodide. We're then going to take 2 cm cubed of bromine water and add it to the potassium chloride and potassium iodide. And finally, we're going to take 2 cm cubed of the iodine water. We're going to add that to potassium chloride and potassium bromide and observe any reactions that occur.
As you can see, a color change has occurred, which suggests that the chlorine has displaced the bromine from the potassium bromide and also the iodine from the potassium iodide, therefore suggesting that it's more reactive.
Also, when bromine water was added to potassium chloride and potassium iodide, only one reaction took place. Potassium iodide changed color, suggesting that the chlorine is more reactive than the bromine. However, the bromine is more reactive than the iodine, allowing it to be displaced. And finally, when iodine was added to both potassium bromide and potassium chloride, no reaction took place, suggesting that iodine is the least reactive of the three halogens we have here. So for the final part of the experiment, guys, we're going to try and extract the halogens from the water that it's dissolving using an organic solvent. The solvent we're going to use is cyclohexane, and as I previously mentioned, it is quite harmful, so try to avoid inhaling the gas and stop at the test tube as soon as you've added them together.
So you're first going to add your cyclohexane to your chlorine water. Secondly, cyclohexane to your bromine water. Finally, you're going to add your cyclohexane to your iodine water.
Now, as we can see here, guys, 2 immiscible layers have formed once we've added cyclohexane, and we can see the color has moved from the water layer into the cyclohexane layer. And this is because halogens are diatomic, which means that they're non-polar. Likewise, the cyclohexane, our organic solvent, is also non-polar. Therefore, the halogens prefer to move out of the water and into the organic solvent, as you can see here. So our results show that chlorine was able to displace both bromine and iodine from their potassium halide solutions. Also, bromine was able to displace iodine, but not chlorine, and no reaction occurred with iodine. Therefore, the reactivity of the halogens seems to decrease as you move down the group. With chlorine being the most reactive, and iodine being the least reactive. Chlorine has the best ability to gain an electron, as it has the smallest radius,
and therefore the outer orbitals and outer electrons are closer to the nucleus and therefore attracted most. So, as you move down the group of seven halogens, the nuclear radius increases and electron shielding increases, therefore they are less able to attract an electron and form a halide ion. We also saw in our experiment that halogens can be extracted from water using an organic solvent. This is because halogens are diatomic and therefore nonpolar, and they prefer to dissolve in like nonpolar molecules such as our solvent cyclohexane. Well, I've been Simon. That was investigating halogen displacement reactions. And remember guys, when you're gonna...
What's going on?